everybody, and welcome back to my channel. We are back once again, yes, with another Evercade video. And in this video, we will be reviewing the Pico collection number one. Same as before, I'll do a brief introduction, capture what games are on there, have a look at some gameplay for a couple of the games, and give my final thoughts on the cartridge. So without further ado, let's roll the game footage. Okay, so let's have a look at what games are on here then. So first up, we have an 8-bit platformer from 1988 called Eight Eyes. We then have Brave Battle Saga, 1996 16-bit role-playing game. Canon, The Legend of the New Gods, 1996, again 16-bit role-playing game. Draken, a 1989 16-bit role-playing game. Dragon View, a 1994 16-bit role-playing game. I see a pattern in this cartridge, to be fair. Dork and Imp, I assume that is, a 16-bit platformer from the 1990s. Iron Commando from 1995, a 16-bit beat-em-up. The Immortal from 1990, a 16-bit RPG role-playing game. Jim Power, The Lost Dimensions, 1993 16-bit platformer. Magic Girl, a 1993 16-bit shooter. Nightshade, a 1992 8-bit action adventure. Power Pigs and the Dark Age, 1996 16-bit platformer. Power Punch 2, a 1992 8-bit sports title. Radical Rex, a 1994 16-bit action game. Switchblade, a 1989 16-bit platformer. The Humans, a 1992 16-bit puzzler. Tinhead, 1993 16-bit platformer. Top Racer, 1992 16-bit racing game. Way of the Exploding Fist, a 1985 8-bit fighting game. Water Margin, a 1996 16-bit beat-em-up. And then we're back to Eight Eyes. So let's roll some game footage then. Okay, so first up we have Magic Girl, which is the shooter that's on here. I really like how colourful it is. Try to avoid some of these bullets. There's a lot going on the screen. I imagine some people will see this and think, well, it's probably pretty simple to play. Why are they coming from behind me? This looks pretty simple in terms of the picture, but it's pretty difficult. What's that? No. So yeah, it's on the face of it, you'd think it was easy given the sort of cartoony nature of it, but it's definitely not the easiest, or I'm not the best at it. I'm not great at shoot-em-ups anyway, but this does seem to be quite a magical, colourful bullet hell game. Things just seem to come from nowhere and get me. I'd love to know if there's an easier way to play this. I'd imagine somebody like Dylan Hyper Trigger X might know, or might have played this. Maybe there's a trick that I'm missing. I don't know. I think I'm on my last life, so we'll get as many of these through, just get as far through as I can with this one life, and we'll move on to the next game. I've got no idea how you're supposed to play this, if I'm even playing it right. But yeah, it's not, don't let the cartoon graphics fool you, this is not an easy game by the looks of things. I'm getting creamed. I don't know whether it's just a continuous thing that you've got to go for a high score, whether there's specific levels, things just appear out of nowhere. Oh, I've got full life again. Christ, no, what the hell? I don't know what those big yellow things are. They don't seem to die. What's this do? It destroys everything on screen. Whoa! Does this bubble protect me? Certainly looks that way. Try and avoid as many of these bullets as I can. As I say, I'm not very good at shooting up, so... So yeah, it might be easy for some people who destroy everything on screen again. And again. And again. Just all. Yeah, I've no idea if there's specific levels or whether it's just a continuous thing. Oh, what's happening here? Seem to be flying up some waterfall. Okay, is this going to take me to a boss, I wonder? Yes, so it appears there are certain levels that you... This shell boss? Whoa! Yeah, I'm gonna die in a minute. Okay. I'm not gonna continue to let people punish people watching me play this. Let's move on to the next game. Okay, so next up we have Power Pigs, I think it's called. Yeah, Power Pigs of the Dark Ages. So let's take a look. I'll start. It looks... Okay, so butt slam. How do we do that? Ah, you just use down. Okay. Okay. Is that floating up? I quite like the art style on this. It's quite interesting. Oh, don't fall on spikes, by the way. It's interesting art style. Has potential. So I'll need to play a bit more of it, but it has potential. It's a sort of action platformer. I'm trying to think what it reminds me of. There have been similar games in the past that have this sort of style where you're... I guess Earthworm Jim sort of fits in the fighting platform style. But isn't actually the same idea. I'm going to land on spikes again because I'm an idiot. Yeah, all in all, this has definitely got potential to be a decent game on this cartridge when I actually get to play it a bit more, but I as with the rest of the games that I've seen on the Evercade, none of them are easy. Well, you wouldn't want them to be easy, but none of them are particularly simple. I guess that is a hot, goes back to games of the past not being as easy as modern, some modern games are of their equivalents. Why can't I land on this platform? Am I jumping wrong? Oh, there we go. So yeah, I'm dead now. It's another one of those games that's definitely got potential. But yeah, let's move on to the next game. Okay, so next up we have Radical Rex. Put it on easy, as per usual, just whilst I'm practicing. Skip the story. So, you are a dinosaur who skateboards, it seems. Probably don't want to walk into that. Stock. So maybe I'm supposed to use the to jar. There we go. Yeah, I need to remap my buttons, that's for sure. Again, very, very colourful game. I like it's very got some good art style like, once more. Much like effectively, you've got to go around and collect these eggs and not die. Again, this is going to be another one I'm going to have to revisit. It's got massive amounts of potential to be another one of those games that should be semi-decent. I like the platform elements. I was hoping for more out of skateboard at the start, to be fair. Don't jump in the lava. Yeah, so I need to remap my buttons. Because I've got them set wrong. But yeah, this is another. I quite like these more modern cartridges, I will admit, over some of the older things like the Atari stuff. Yay, more skateboard. So I don't know how much control you have over this skateboard. It doesn't look like you've got a lot. It just basically you. You use it. I'm gonna get to the end of this level where my next death, and then we'll go to another game, and then we'll go back to the games room, and we'll have a chat. But definitely this cartridge, I've had it out to check it works, but I've not really done anything with it other than that. So yeah, I'm happy with that game as well. So yeah, let's move on to the next game. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so we'll go on to the final game. This is Iron Legend. So this is a beat 'em up. This will be the last one because I need to charge the Evercade. So we'll see whether my battery will last the length of time I need to record this. I'm going to skip the story. Anybody who has the Evercade, you know, you can get into the story yourselves. I'm just going to get into the action, give my thoughts on the game, and take it from there. So, we're on 21 Moorgate Street. Putting this guy in the green shirt. They're going to pay for this, I assume, is in reference to the story. It's a very Streets of Rage-esque, shall I say. Another game, series of games I'm not the best at. How much life do these guys have? I didn't change any settings or anything, so that could be that. We'll do my first life and then carry on. But yeah, it's apologies. A second, I'm getting absolutely whooped. Oh, I used a special and didn't mean to. I should get rid of them, I would hope. How have you still got life? There we go. Oh, Jack's me, not them. It was me thinking that they had massive amounts of life. I'm actually Jack. So yeah, so there's a lot of, I guess it's going to be the comparison you'll get with a lot of these games to the likes of Streets of Rage or even possibly Double Dragon, which incidentally is on one of the cartridges that I will be reviewing. So yeah, this is it's not an easy beat 'em up. Imagine most beat 'em ups from this era weren't that easy from memory. Again, I think it's, what the hell's going on here? Okay, my network seems to have died. One good thing about the Evercade not being on being an internet based thing is that I don't have to rely on the internet to play games on it. Oh, you can beat the car up, I see. As well as beating the guys up, you're effectively beating the car up at the same time. I see the life at the bottom there. Let's drop that on them, see what happens to the truck. Probably nothing. How little did that take off that truck? I'm going to get to try and beat this truck up, and then we'll go back to the games room and review once I sort my internet out. If I can stop these guys knifing me. There we go, truck's done. Tino, come here. Right. So that is the end of the first level. Difficult game so far, and this is only the first level. Or I think it's the end of the first level anyway. It's letting me collect these, so I would hope that's, oh no, maybe a mid-level boss. Let's just get to that point. Right, let's pause that there. So yeah, I'm mightily impressed in terms of that game as well, but let's go back to the games room and finish up and review the rest of the cartridge. Okay folks, so we're back in the games room. My turn that off. My battery did manage to last, so let me play that final game in the end. So what are my final thoughts on this Pico collection? All in all, it's a good selection of games. There's quite a lot on here. Something for everybody, really. I'm really looking forward to getting into some more of the RPGs. I didn't want to try and cover an RPG on the gameplay footage. mainly because they take a long time to play. So yeah, I'm looking forward to getting into the RPGs. I like that there's quite a lot on here, but I also like there's the mix of some puzzles and some platformers and some more action style beat 'em ups, some more fast paced games. So yeah, all in all, very, very good cartridge. What would I say was the favourite game that I played? Now, having I didn't play that many that long on the RPG, so I can't really give those say any of those would be. So excluding the RPGs on here, probably the Humans would have been my favourite game. I think I didn't actually feature any gameplay for footage of the Humans, and I'm not so sure why. It's a puzzle platform type game where you get control of humans and you've got them to direct them to certain places and form certain things. I quite like that. It would either be that or probably Water Margin. That said, the older games on here are very good games. There isn't a really bad one out of them all, bar what I would say would be Power Punch 2. That's just because I don't like that style of boxing game where you semi, it's sort of like 2.5D, if you will. You're looking over the shoulder of your boxer and you've got to try and land punches. It was playable, but it wasn't my favourite. It was similar to one of the ones that was on the Atari cartridge, and I can't remember what that one was called. But yeah, all in all, it's a good cartridge. I will probably try and do some individual reviews of the RPGs on here. Maybe lump those into the 5-minute reviews that I do. Capture some footage of me playing them, see what, and give my thoughts on them, and actually get into the storyline of them. I do like this cartridge. Anybody who hasn't picked up the Pico cartridge, I would strongly recommend that you do. Funstock have still got it, from what I can gather, in stock, and you can also pick it up on at your usual retailers such as Amazon and Argos. Amazon and Argos were selling them at a reasonably cheap price, but buying them from Funstock means that the money goes back to the owners of the console directly, and then they can then use that to potentially get us more collections. So yeah, all in all, good cartridge, excellent set of games. I was trying not to do halves, so I'll probably give this actually a 4, just based on the collection alone, the amount of games that are on it, and the amount of differing styles that are on it as well. Really, really highly recommended cartridge. And that's it. All that's left for me to do then is thank you for watching. I have been the Ignored Nerd, and I'll catch you on the next one.